Hello students, in the last video we discussed about macroeconomics first chapter introduction, the introduction of macroeconomics and meaning of macroeconomics and the differences between microeconomics and macroeconomics. Just the meaning of microeconomics. Macroeconomics, it studies the small things. It means individuals, consumers, individual producers, prices, etc. It will be studied in a microeconomics. In the macroeconomics means macroeconomics studies the entire economy. It studies the entire or whole economy. It means macroeconomics refers to the study of aggregative covering the entire economy, such as general employment, general price level and wage level, aggregated demand and supply, national income and output, interest rate and cost structure, theory of money, etc. We are studying in the macroeconomics. This is called macroeconomics. Macro means a lot, micro means a small. In the macroeconomics we are studying the individual, and in the macroeconomics we are studying the entire or a whole economy. And in this video, we are discussing about the continued part of the first chapter of macroeconomics. Nature of macroeconomics. What is the nature of macroeconomics? Here, the nature of macroeconomics explains you the current theme of the economy. It studies the economic activities as a whole, and it helps us to understand how the economy functions in a different situation. These different situations tell us how the macro analysis finds solution for major issues. The way of a solution is called the nature of macroeconomics. The situation which are studied and solved by macroeconomics. Here, first one, the nature of macroeconomics, first one, how to generate and spend the income through production of goods and services. It's how it's generate and spends the income of the nation. How? It means through the production of goods and services. This one is the first nature of macroeconomics. And how to allocate the human resources and non-human resources. It means human resources means natural resources and man-made resources in a different economic sector to increase the level of GDP. And how and what policies regarding production and income expenditure be formulated for the growth of a different of an economy. And next, fourth one, here what policies should be formulated regarding foreign trade to serve the interest of people at large here. And what policies should be formulated regarding the foreign trade? It means external trade, export and imports of goods and services, etc. And fifth one here, how the different variables like output level, price level and employment level bear close relationship. Here, what the relationship between our differences variables like output level is a different, prices and employment level, the price level will be increases, output to how it is increase or decreases, everything we are studying in macroeconomics. And here, these variables have a tendency to rise or fall simultaneously, and similarly the employment level goes up and down as per the output level and price level. These are the nature of macroeconomics. It means its nature is a scope or a nature. Here scope and nature are very high. It means whole economy we are studying in macroeconomics. Here, thus the macroeconomics is a study of the economic problem of a nation as a whole. It analyzes the ways and means to solve them. All the problems give the solutions by the macroeconomics. And here, the scope of macro economics. What is the scope? Scope ಏನೈತಿದ್ರದ್ದು, ವ್ಯಾಪ್ತಿ ಏನೈತಿದ್ರದ್ದು, ಎಷ್ಟು ದೂರ ಹರಡೈತಿದ್ರ ವ್ಯಾಪ್ತಿ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಐತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ನೋಡೋಣ. ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್ ಐ ಗಿವನ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಅಂಡರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್. ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ರೋ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಕವರ್ಸ್ ಅ ವೈಡ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ economic variables such as a national income, aggregate employment, money, general price level and aggregate demand and supply, consumption, investment, expenditure, etc. These variables are the important components of the subject matter of a macroeconomics. The scope of a macroeconomics can be explained as a follow. Given here, follow the scopes here. First one, major sectors here. The economy in a democratic setup has many major interdependent sectors like household sector. Household sector means the family sectors, household sector, and each sector plays household sector, producer sector, it means business sector, government sector, social sector, and external foreign sector. External sector means here foreign sector. Happens to each sector will be reflected in the economy as a whole. While studying the economy, macroeconomist should consider each sector for a complete study of the macroeconomy. Here in the macroeconomics studies the major sectors. According to major sector, household sector, producer sector, it means business sector, government sector, external sector, extra, etc. We are studying in the macroeconomics. And the second scope of macroeconomics, second one, here national income. Here national income. Here we studies the various concept of national income such as GDP, here NDP and GNP, NNP, personal income and per capita income. This will be studied in a second chapter, national income analysis second chapter is there. We are completely studying about the national income in the second chapter of macroeconomics, meaning of a national income and what is GDP, what is NDP, here GNP, NNP and personal income and per capita income. We are complete study in the second chapter of macroeconomics. And general employment, here general employment is very important. Employment is very important here. Theory of employment, the scope of macroeconomics covers here. Theory of employment, we are studying the theories of employment. Determinants of employment and unemployment are the issues in macroeconomics. This is unemployment is the main issue in the macroeconomics. It means every 5 years plan, we taken the objectives of full employment, creation of the full employment, but still now we are not completely taken the full employment in a country. We are facing our country is facing main problem is unemployment, poverty and unemployment, but macroeconomics also not given the complete solutions to the unemployment at present also. And it studies the facts like here macroeconomics studies the fact of the unemployment in and it gives the solutions also, but still also we are facing some unemployment percentage, some percentage of the unemployment problem. And it studies the fact like aggregative demand, aggregative supply, aggregative consumption and aggregative savings and aggregative investment, and which determine the aggregative employment also we are studying. And next fourth one here, theory of general price. Theory of general price in macroeconomics studies the determinants of, it means here the macroeconomics studies the determinants of a general price level and inflation and depletion are the important components of macroeconomics. Here the theories of general price, the inflation and depletion also depending on the prices. Suppose what is inflation, Inflation means continuously prices are rising in a market. That is known as the inflation. And more supply of money in a market. That is called inflation. And deflation means continuously reducing the prices in a market. And money supply is less in a market. That is known as the deflation. Are the important components of macroeconomics. We are complete. We are studying in the next chapters of inflation and deflation. Here, it will be depending on the general price level. General price level means whole goods, all the goods and services, the price of the all goods and services. That is a general price level. All whole prices in it. All product do prices in include individual in the whole prices of the market. That is called general prices. And fifth one, it is a theory of money. Here we are studying the theory of money in the third or fourth chapter. We are studying the money chapter. We are studying about the money. It means here included banking system, everything included. It means what are included in the theory of money? Disequilibrium between the demand and supply of money. Yavag demand increase agutte money demand and supply, and yavag decrease agutte when it is a decrease, when it is increase of the money, the quantity of money. It means demand of money and supply of money. It means has an impact. It means a disequilibrium between a demand and supply of money has an impact on the level of employment and production. To bring equilibrium between these two macroeconomic studies, the monetary policies and monetary policies, it's to bring equilibrium between two these demand and supply. The monitor, it means macroeconomic studies, the monetary policies and fiscal policies and other related policies. It will be taken the monetary policies, it means regarding the money, and fiscal policy, it is called in Kannada Rajaniti. And next, fiscal policy means in the improvement in the policies taken in the taxation, and next expenditures, that is known as the fiscal policy. And next, already you studied in the about the fiscal policy in the first PUC, and it will be studied in the next chapters. And international trade, macroeconomics studies the international trade and export, import, exchange rate and balance of payment are the major issues in this context. Here, international trade also included in the macroeconomics. We know that here export of goods and services and imports of goods and services and exchange rates. Exchange rates means foreign exchange rate. Foreign exchange rate means what they are fixed the rate of currencies, one currency to another currency. That is known as the foreign exchange rates. And balance of payment, BOP, balance of payment means export and import of export mat import goods madidr mele agiddanta payment anna nav en martive antandre aa ond BOP olag list olag nav en martive kudustivi adnanna neevu last chapter olag study martiri. But international trade also very important. It is very incomparable to the nation, and very important to the study of the international trade. Any international trade, there have issues in the international trade. It the solutions given by the macroeconomics. These are the scope and nature of macroeconomics. Next, I will in the next video I will explain about the emergence of macroeconomics. Macroeconomics heng bant annodanna nav en madona andre study madona. Okay, ee video like ishta agidre nimge like madre, subscribe madre. Thank you.